What's going on, YouTube? Chevy Brother checking back in with you. I just popped back on here to show you guys what I just picked up. I just got a new motor in. It's the 1512 Kessel. It's 2650 kV. Now, I got one thing for you guys. If you guys can tell me if this is the real deal or is this a knockoff. Now, I'm going to go ahead and unbox this thing, and you guys tell me, is it real or is it a knockoff? Here we go. We're going to go ahead and crack it open. All right. You guys see the foam. I know JM Spec, he showed you what to look for in his videos where you could tell the real Kessel from the fake. But yeah, go ahead and check the foam out here. See that? Okay. Well, this is the motor here. We'll go ahead and pull that on out so you guys can see that. See, it says Kessel on there, made in China, all that good stuff. All right, there's the motor. Okay, now the box, that's everything that was in the box. This is the foam. Okay, go ahead and take that out. Whoops, that's the foam. That's the top foam. Let's see what else is in the box here. Okay, nada. I'll show you guys the box. But yeah, that was all that was in the box. Okay. All right, let you guys have another look at the motor here, get everything out. Okay. These are the wires. If you look really closely, see that? Now, anybody who actually paid attention to a counterfeit and a real Kessel will be able to tell me if this is a knockoff or if this is the real deal just by looking at that. All right, looking more at the motor. Yeah, 1512, 2650 kV. Looks like a Kessel. Kind of handles like a Kessel. But see, here's the thing. When you turn this, that's how you know the difference. But I just want to show you guys my new motor. I'm going to show you guys some other things with the C10. Hold on one second. All right, guys. I'm back with the C10. As you well see, she's got a new paint job. I've been doing some body work on the C10 here. And I know in my other video, I showed the body, it looked kind of rough. So basically what I did, I took a heat gun, you know, tried to heat the body up some here to knock this dent out. I kind of did it with a lighter underneath the body. Got most of the dent out, you know, heated up some, push it out. And, you know, I got the dent out here. It's still a little rippled. This here was real bad. I got it out, you know, it's not terrible, but I got the dent out the body. I'll let you guys check out the body here. I'll get this motor out of the way. But yeah, I'll let you guys check out the body more. It does have a metallic flake paint job. This is not RC paint, and I'll say it again, this is not RC car paint. This is Rust-Oleum again. I know the first Rust-Oleum paint job I had flaked off, but this, I did a different process of painting this. I actually scuffed this outside body down, primed it, put a real thick coat of primer on there, and then the Rust-Oleum, this is metallic flake paint, and I put a really thick coat on that on top of the primer. So we're gonna see, you know, if it actually stand up to, you know, the rigors of running on an RC car, you know, the flexing and everything with the body. So I'm gonna give that a try. My paint masking wasn't the best, but you know, like I said, this whole thing, this bodywork thing is kind of new to me, so that's why I'm trying out different things to see what'll work. Just trying that. I'm gonna go ahead and crack the hood and show you guys what's going on underneath there. Not too much going on underneath the hood. We still got her torn down to fit, you know, for repairs and stuff. This motor's coming out, different gears, everything else. Guess what's going in here? This bad boy here is going to take the place of Old Blue. I know you guys are tired of seeing Old Blue. Old Blue's been in almost every project I've built, and so that's why we went ahead and popped and got a new motor. We want to go a little faster, throw up some better numbers. We're going to see what this motor will do. Now, the challenge I threw out there was, if you could tell me if this is a real Castle motor or a knockoff, that's the challenge. So, you guys put your answers in the comments down here. Let me know. That's all for now. Rate, comment, subscribe. Give me a thumbs up. And as always, keep RC and keep wrenching. Peace.